interviews a contributor. I contributed to the book which I've lent him. And in fact, brother's very, very long friend, long time friend, Rikki Wemega-Kwawu.
Thank you. Person, Madam Boskofi. Madam Boskofi, was a friend to my late mother. She was also a teacher. She taught for so many years. She taught my other sister, who is in the States, and my our last born in Agri Memorial in Sekondi. And she taught my other sister at Copenhagen. Yeah. So I've known Madam Boskofi since childhood. And Honorable Papa Owusu-Ankomah. I'm just like a member of the Owusu-Ankomah family. I was in school with Brother Owusu-Ankomah. He was a year ahead of me. We were in Old Hospital Experimental School, where you have the present Ghana Exams Council. Yeah, that used to be the Old Hospital Experimental School. And I'll probably say it was the best school at that time because we used to talk the common language. And the brother was a year ahead of me. And the two of us were actually the best in that school at that time. And whenever I came to drawing class, all our mates congregated around us. Brother's class had another mate of his called Derek Afo. Yeah. And so, we were equally good in other subjects, but when it came to art, we were unmatched. And brother finished, after elementary school, I went into St. John's. Brother went to Ghana. Straight from elementary school, he wanted to be a professional, so he went to Ghana. And he started his professional work. Though quite early, I remember he started his exhibitions. I used to visit him, I was in secondary school. And brother had a tiny studio, and what frustrated him so much, he would be painting. The studio was so poorly lit, all those places someday will turn into a museum, I'll digress, but Papa talked about brother used to paint the bedroom, he had paintings all over, and he painted over one brother loved for, Now, there's the technology, for removing the painting and having access, to the painting behind. So I believe we can still access that painting when the time comes. And brother used to paint, and instead of throwing the empty tubes away, he used to throw them into a corner, in that tiny studio. And that was what frustrated me most whenever I visited him, He had the moving power of those empty tubes, And we decided so early, to dedicate our lives to to art. I remember when I expressed to brother, I wanted to pursue art professionally. He told me, I had to count the cost, and be prepared to pay for it. And I said, I was ready to pay whatever dues there was in for that. So we embarked on our profession together. Our parents were friends, and the brother had to leave for a wise thing behind, except when I had to be traveling outside. And it's been a long, arduous journey. We talk often on the phone, encouraging ourselves. You really have to have a steel skin to stay on course as an artist. I remember our brother would send me catalogs. I'll visit Papa at that time. He had his legal practice in Takoradi. Call on him, call on Brother Frimpong to show them Brother's latest achievement. I'll visit his late daddy, show him what Brother was doing. And he kept me up to date about his achievement. Now, I'm proud of how he's regarded as one of the greatest living painters, not just from Africa, but globally, the whole world. And one of Africa's most important artists in the world. He's had so many museum shows. Right from the beginning, we promised ourselves, because we're reading about all the great artists, Michael. Michelangelo, who were reading about Leonardo da Vinci, Picasso, and the two of us were determined, you know, to feel like those, you know, people. We thought, you know, what they attained in life was attainable, you know, perhaps, you know, so nothing could cow us, you know, one bit, you know. We're prepared to face whatever, whether it was poverty. So, and brother has paid his dues, you know, as an artist.
Yeah.
You know, his late father told me a story about a year or two before passed. Though I remember those days periodically, he and the mother would just, you know, go on a trip around the world, visit their kids in Europe, in America. And the father told me, you know, he visited brother, and he saw, I only didn't describe it as squalor, you know, but the brother living, you know, his living condition. He couldn't believe that was his son, you know, somebody who had been provided with everything and had denied all that to take to the hustle life of the artist. Well, he said that was when he really came to terms with brother's decision to pursue his career as an artist. And that was when he gave him his fullest blessing that, you know, my son, you're going to be a great artist someday. And he never told this to brother, but he told me this, you know, before he passed on. He said he couldn't believe it, you know, that, you know, brother coming from, you know, this background, you know, where everything was provided for, and brother living the life of denial in Germany. So he thought brother really had a true spirit on the heart. And he's gone so far. And, you know, it's been a very arduous journey, as I said earlier. And we still haven't realized our biggest dreams. We have real big dreams. And I remember when the two of us had an invitation to show the Metropolitan Museum and the Great Gallery in New York. The one friend of mine called me, Rikki, you know, you've always talked about you're going to show at the Museum of Modern Art, you know. It's just like you were joking, you know, but it appears to be coming true. I said, no, my career was well-defined to me right from the beginning. I knew I was going to show at the Museum of Modern Art, and, you know, we are close. And, you know, the Museum of Modern Art is just a sister museum to the Metropolitan Museum. So I believe that the ultimate, you know, we're going to get there. And yeah, so it's been, you know, very interesting. We encourage ourselves, and we've been on the road, you know, the journey hasn't ended. And brother seriously contemplating coming back home. And this book, you know, the Microcron begins, though, you know, it's actually a combination of his achievements, and it was declared by the University of African Arts, an online intellectual platform, as the best book on art in 2014. And what makes it a very extraordinary book is, apart from the quality of production, the pictures, you know, of brother's work, you know, very high quality reproduction. You know, the intellectualism has been exhibited, you know, in this thing by very top scholars around the world, you know, makes it extraordinary. You never find any book on African art with that level of in-depth intellectual discourse, you know. And another thing which makes it so unique is, it's not just, normally in the past, you always find Europeans, you know, writing about African artists. So if there was a book out on African artists, all the essays would be, you know, will be Europeans or Americans. And for the first time, your brother had Africans contributing to, you know, his book. You know, there was Professor Moyo Okudeji in Texas, at the University of Texas, Austin. And there was Oluwatoyin, you know, he's a philosopher, you know, in London. And I'm very honored to have been part of the essays. And you know, it's a world mix of Europeans and Africans, you know, who contributed to writing that book. And it makes it so exceptional, you know, I mean, one of its kind, you know. And though I congratulate brother, you know, for this very great